Hey guys, welcome to another game. This has been a great matchup, honestly, I think, thus far. We have Grast in the upper right-hand corner as the blue Protoss bottom left-hand corner. We have Adame as the, I'm never sure what to call this color. It's like tan or orange or kind of creamish. This color. It's this color is Adame. We're actually trying to discuss. Adame, if you end up seeing this, by the way, and I am mispronouncing your name, let me know. I want to know how to pronounce it correctly. It's just Adame on most of the replays, which is why I'm going with that. But it is possible. People are saying, you know, maybe it's Adame. Adame kicks. It's kind of the True Touch thing that we were discussing in chat. And who knows? Ooh, are we going to see cheese? I think we're going to see cheese. Grast is moving a very early. Yeah, before Pylon, Probe Scout out in the corner. So I think he wants to go ahead and get into that final match ahead of Adame. And he's going to. Ooh. Two player map. So this is extremely risky in a lot of regards because being a two player map, it is challenging to pull this off. Yeah. And actually, I like what Adame is doing. He's how does he know this? He's kind of he did that probe sweep just in case. Maybe feeling that, okay, Grasp is a little bit cheesy with that DT follow-up in the main. It's going to come down to this probe and when it's sent out. If he had sent it right after Pylon, that would have been it. I think the gig would have been up. But now he's getting that gateway down. Waiting for the first gateway. It's going to be double gateway, most likely, before Pylon. Oh, is he going to? No, he's not going to scout out to the right. He's going to know immediately as soon as this probe gets up. But the question is it going to matter or not? Is it going to matter or not? And I'm almost wondering if a second probe was put out to provide some blockade. There's the second gateway down now. Additional probe moving in to provide the additional timing. Fortunately for Adame, he's got two gateways of his own. So he is on an equivalent build. And he's going to know momentarily. And we'll see how he decides to adjust. So two gateway versus two gateway. The proximity is going to give the advantage to Grast overall. Still might be able to get some harassment done. So yeah, now Adame knows something's up. Does he decide to put down a shield battery? Does he decide to continue with his standard build is the question. Second pylon along the main, trying to harass that probe as best he can. Zealot about halfway finished there. He is going to have a Zealot out sooner. Ooh, I think that's a proxy pylon to block in a couple of these probes. I don't think he really caught. Well, maybe he caught one probe. I think he caught one probe with that. Zealot's just going to camp on the ramp, and that is going to make. It's going to come down to micro with two Zealots out in the field. Probe moving his way back up for Adame to try to get eyes. So what's going to be critical here is whether he sees that Vespin Geyser running or not. If there's no Vespin Geyser, he knows it's not all that tricky. He can just play accordingly. And also, Grast's got to get a move on because he's got this pylon on here, right? And he's going to have to rely on that for supply. So first two Zealots moving their way out, additional Zealots flooding through, two Zealots versus two Zealots. It's going to be micro going up the ramp. Keep in mind, I don't think Zealot misfire plays into account. And honestly, with the two gateways, I think Adame should be fine here. We'll see. Zealots engaging. Zealots working on that left-hand Zealot. Unfortunately, some nice micro there from Adame pushing back around. Is he going to try to file that third Zealot in? Now working on that Zealot on the right. Yeah, doing a quick exchange. Accidentally attacking his own Zealot a little bit there, which is not going to help in the overall fight. Still trying to press his way up this ramp, but you can see the reinforcements just coming in and some nice Zealot juggling from Adame. So three Zealots still sitting here waiting on the low ground. And I think that might be all she wrote for Grast. We'll see. Trying to poke there and actually providing a larger spread now. So even with a closer reinforcement point, it's not going to make a difference because the concavity is just going to be in Adame's favor. And eventually that pylon's going to get taken out, and it's just that should be it. Five Zealots on the high ground, which is definitely going to beat the three Zealots on the low ground. And with these two additional Zealots, we'll see if Adame decides to get aggressive. So I think the cheese was there, but unfortunately not executed. I think Grast realizes he's all in at this stage, so he's pulling all of the probes off the line to try to engage. So this is going to be 10 probes, 4 Zealots. We got 5. 4 Zealots, 5 Zealots engaging. Adame moving across. Great surround on the Zealots. Good micro on his part. And that is before the probes are even able to engage. And he's going to pin one Zealot back. That's GG. I don't think there's any recovery from that. Now the probes coming across the line, maybe with some just absolute genius micromanagement, this would be a follow-up. But I think, yeah, he's just going to let them in and then re-engage on the ramp. He needs to make sure the rest of these Zealots are in fact engaging, though. All he has to do is keep producing Zealots here, and that'll be a match. That should be it. The probes trying to get some sort of harassment where they're doing some sort of disruption, but honestly, two Zealots versus this. Yeah, there's GG. I like the little. I got caught. The little smiley face right there. Gonna move on to game 3 in the losers match. Hope you guys enjoyed that one. Thanks for listening.